Welcome. Welcome to Dixon High School graduation 2020. What a special evening we have. Please stand and continue standing until the graduates are seated.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we've watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you.
It is my pleasure at this time to introduce salutatorian Tierra Weed. Is the daughter of Angel and Nick Weed. Tierra has earned a cumulative GPA of 4.242 on a 4.0 scale. Tierra has been involved in many clubs throughout her high school career. She was involved in Pep Club, A+, Key Club, and National Honor Society. She also participated in basketball her freshman year and softball her freshman and sophomore year. Tierra plans to attend William Woods University in Fulton, Missouri to obtain a degree in criminal justice while pursuing a minor in psychology. Congratulations, Tierra.
All right, hello class of 2020. Before I fully begin, we should thank everyone, like the school staff, the faculty, and just anyone who put all this together. Though there's been many changes, they've worked really hard to like accommodate everyone and make for sure that we all got here. So I'd like to personally thank you for your hard work and consideration. But on the other hand, I am glad to see that everyone is here, but with Corona quarantine and online schooling, they couldn't really fail us, so that's a plus. I look around and I do see a unique class, and with everything that's happened, we have an even more unique year to graduate from. So, as a class, we've struggled a lot. Not with just online schooling, canceling prom, canceling senior trip, witnessing the riots, struggling with our own graduation, and so much more. But we've struggled as a class, and we've struggled to get along. And as we take a big step in our lives, I do feel like this should be a big eye-opener. Our class needs to see the problems in the real world and notice that our class and generation needs to stick together. None of us are innocent, and I do fully include myself in this, and we've all been hard to get along with. And I don't want to see no one disagreeing because we all know that we've been really hard to get along with. So I hope in adulthood we help our peers and people in our lives more than what we have in the past. And as the world gets more and more cruel, we need to stand up for what we think is right. And we got to do it together. So our class is very unique and we had a difficult year to graduate from. So out of anyone, we should help those in need because we've struggled the most. So. And I know I'm standing in front of all of you, and you really don't want to listen to me. You don't care, and you've heard this a million times. But maybe hearing it from a peer will, open your eyes a little bit more. So, this is just kind of like the last time I can make an impact on you before we all separate. But I look around, and I see potential in everyone. I do. But when I look around, I also see that we have a lot of growing up to do. I fully include myself in that. I know it might sound harsh, but with the world we're going into, it's going to be nothing but harsh. So many of us will go through rough patches, and we're going to need someone. So we need to face this head on, and I'm not going to lie, I've always struggled with this. I used to think that no one can help me, and I knew everything. But just by signing up for college, I realized that I know literally nothing. But if we don't step up to the plate and we don't get ready for this, there's going to be no one to help us and no one to help a younger generation. So I think it is time for us to fully grow up. Now, with all this being said, that's it. I hope it wasn't too painful and I got this situation addressed appropriately. And this is all something that we did fight through. And though this wasn't your typical graduating speech, we aren't your typical graduating class. And so this year might have been scattered, but just know that our grandchildren, we can tell a story about the toilet paper shortage of 2020. Congratulations, everyone.
Thank you.
It's truly my pleasure at this time to introduce 2020 ballot Victorian, Silas Aaron Young. Silas is the son of Diana and Jeremy Young. Silas has earned a cumulative GPA of 4.254 on a 4.0 scale. Throughout his high school career, Silas has been a member of many clubs, including National Honor Society, band, and A+. He also attended Boys State his junior year. After graduation, Silas plans to attend Missouri S&T to major in biological science before transferring to University of Missouri in St. Louis optometry program to become a doctor in optometry. Congratulations.
Hello, class of 2020. I have to say that I barely recognize most of you because I've been stuck inside my house for so long. It's been, what, like since 4 months since we last roamed the halls of our high school? I almost forgot that we had a baseball field. In all seriousness, though, I would like to congratulate all of us and say that we did it. I know it was rough, and I know that our senior year was not quite like we hoped it would be. Prom was canceled, sports just died, and our lives in general were turned upside down. However, despite these adversities, we managed to conquer the barrier that is high school, and I've turned out to be fine and accomplished young men and women. Now, I think this unusual time has probably taught us a little something about our lives, or maybe about the world. Maybe we learned that how much we rely on people, or maybe the isolation was nice for a change. Maybe we learned that we need more family time in our lives, or that the teacher's class that we dreaded going to was not so bad after all. I know that I've learned some things about myself and the world, and I want to share a few of those with you. So for starters, don't take the things and privileges that you have in your life for granted, because everything that you feel belongs to us can be taken away, I think, in the blink of an eye. I think most of us can agree that this virus has done a lot more than just make people sick. People have lost their jobs, and the world has been plunged into a constant state of fear. However, people each and every day are choosing to not let these negative aspects dictate their lives. Churches are reassembling, friends are gathering to see one another again, and people are resuming work. This might have felt like the longest 4 months of our lives, but it's just a small portion of this year. So do not be discouraged, class of 2020. There are so many great things ahead of each and every one of our lives. So do not let this small, dark time define you, and instead rise above it and reap all the benefits that your hard work has earned you. So I ask each and every one of you to not give up hope, and I pray that as things start to shift back to normal, we will be able to go out into the world as more thankful and stronger people, and that those broken things in your lives will start to be rebuilt. I especially hope that these good things happen for our graduating class as well, because to be honest, becoming functioning, successful adults is hard enough. The second thing that I learned is that friendships and connections with people matter, and I think that this time has proven that to be more than anything else. I think sometimes we become used to having particular people in our lives, and we almost forget how important they are to us until one day they can no longer be with us. I truly do believe that friendships and connections with people matter, and I think that this time has certainly brought out the best in people and has made me truly grateful for the people that I have in my life. I would now like to thank some of those people that I have in my life that have made everything that I've been able to accomplish possible. I'd like to thank all of my teachers for helping me when things got tough and for offering me support anytime I needed it. I would like to thank all of my our counselor, Mrs. Kirk, our amazing principal, Mr. Bohr, for being so supportive to everyone and involved throughout the school. I think we all agree that he has made DHS so much brighter and lively during his time here. I would like to deeply thank all of those that have been closest to me throughout high school and my life. I would like to thank my friends, Abram, Russell, and Nova, for being so loyal, for making my life happy when it felt dark. There are also three other people in my life that I'll be forever thankful for. My lovely sisters, Faith and Grace, for always making my day so cheerful and partaking in some of my hobbies, even when they weren't the girliest. I would also like to thank my amazing grandma, Mimi, for being so supportive, loving, and caring. I would especially like to thank my amazing parents for being such a big part of my life. They have supported me throughout every aspect of my life, and have helped me up when I have fallen and celebrated with me when I have succeeded, so I cannot fully express my love and gratitude for them. This is not only for my special night, but yours as well. I love you, Mom and Dad. let's not only give them a big round of applause, but all the amazing parents that have given their all to help us succeed and surpass every obstacle that we have faced throughout our lives. Most importantly, I would like to thank God for all that He has done for me. He has seen every problem in my life, even when I have hid them from those around me, and has provided me with a rock to stand on when everything within me felt like it was falling apart. He has provided me with all these amazing people that have made me who I am today. I look forward to following Him and fulfilling His plan that He has for me. I think the last and final thing that I've learned is that people love toilet paper more than anyone has ever thought. I wish all the best luck to you. Go out into the world and pursue your goals. I'm proud to be a member of a wonderful graduating class of 2020. Thank you and have a great night.
Ladies and gentlemen, guests and family members, thank you for being here tonight to mark this milestone in your graduate's life. This is a special moment. Graduates, let me just say this plainly. This school year has been a long, strange journey. You have lost much. You have missed opportunities, experiences with friends, games, recitals, concerts, trips, and so much more. I hate that circumstances this spring took so much from you, and I wish I could change that. However, while I cannot change what has happened, I do have one completely foolproof and reliable remedy to help you move past these disappointments. And not only this, but that remedy will help you live a happy and fulfilling life. Does that sound too good to be true? Are you at least a little curious? Allow me a moment to be more specific. What if I told you this same remedy would lead to greater physical and emotional well-being for the rest of your life? What if I said this remedy would help you live longer, in fact, several years longer than your peers that don't have it? What if I said this remedy would help you experience more success in your career and probably end up making you more money if that's important to you? This same remedy will help you thrive in all your personal and professional relationships. And last but not least, this remedy will allow you to find joy in every circumstance. Now, are you just a little more curious? I'm going to tell you, in front of all of these people, I'm going to share a precious gift with you. It's something that's taken a long time for me to learn. The secret is this: learn to be grateful. Learn to say thank you and mean it for everything in your life, even the hard stuff, especially the hard stuff, because it's usually the hard stuff that teaches you the most. Are you wondering how this works? Because I can hear you thinking, Mr. Bohr, how could you possibly suggest I be grateful for so much loss and disappointment in my senior year? And I know that sounds ridiculous. But I've lived long enough to know that practicing gratitude in all circumstances will change your life forever. It'll change your life for the good. So perhaps it'll help you if I share a few things for which I'm grateful in the wake of this pandemic. And while I share my list, maybe you can start thinking about your own. So here we go. I'm not afraid to say it. I'm very thankful that I have not yet run out of toilet paper. Likewise, I am thankful that I haven't run out of hand sanitizer. On a more serious note, I am very thankful for public health officials who've worked tirelessly to keep us all safe. I'm thankful for great teachers who had to reinvent the art and science of teaching in a moment's notice. I'm thankful for bus drivers and maintenance staff who, in many cases, selflessly drove their own vehicles to deliver meals all over this district. I'm thankful for kitchen staff workers who worked each week to prepare hundreds of meals for kids while our buildings were closed. I'm thankful for volunteers in this community who help provide extra meals and ensure their delivery. I'm thankful for skilled secretaries who kept our school offices going amid the chaos and uncertainty. I'm thankful for my fellow principals who kept me laughing even on the most frustrating days. I'm thankful for a supportive superintendent and school board. Now, this next one's a little tougher for me. My father passed away in December, just a couple of months before this madness started. He raised me to be a man of faith, especially in times of struggle. I'm thankful for him and the example of his life. And finally, despite the challenges this year has brought, I am thankful to have served as your principal. I didn't deserve this honor, but I'll always be grateful for walking part of this journey with you. Now, that's a portion of my list. Of course, it's too short. There should be much more on it. But while I was sharing, maybe you were thinking about what should be on your gratitude list. If not, maybe you'll consider in the coming days what should be on it. It should be a long one, I promise you. So I'm going to close with this. My hope is that you will learn to live with a grateful heart. Your assignment following this ceremony is to consider all the things for which you should be thankful. Write that list down, my friends. If there's a someone on that list you should thank, do it. Call them. Even better, handwrite a personal note expressing your gratitude. Please don't text them. You won't regret this effort, I assure you. Graduates, please know that your families, your teachers, and this entire community are extremely proud of you, and we honor your achievements. Well done, and congratulations. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've been waiting for, the presentation of the graduates and their diplomas. Are you ready? Come on. Hold on just a second. Oh, hold on just a second. Let them finish getting to the base of the stairs. There you go. Emilio Jose Acosta. Good job. Taylor Allen Andrade. CJ Lee Baker. Tell Barker. Sophia Marie Bianco, summa cum laude. David P. Bledsoe. Colton Bowman. Cameron Brazel. Hayden Allen Brown. Jaron Dale Brown. Cody James Capel, magna cum laude. Kelsey Marie Chafin. Joseph Maxwell Corsetto.
Did she take a picture?
Okay. You want another one? Okay.
Destiny Deneen Crawford.
Y'all spelled my name wrong. I'm there, it's spelled wrong.
Lily Rebecca Catherine Doba, cum laude.
Thank you, Mr. Board.
Abby Destiny Duncan. Brooklyn Renee Duncan. Cammy Inez Dunlap. Gretchen Lenora Eckert, cum laude. Naomi Sue Etheridge. Casey Renee Foster, cum laude. Wesley Cyan Grissom. Caitlin Dawn Holtzclaw. Trey Young Holzer. Shay Earl Hool. Chloe Sybil Irvin. Emily Nicole Johnson, summa cum laude. David Mario Jones. Emily Marie Jones. Sarah Ann Marie Kelly. Bethany May Koch, cum laude. Donnie James Koch. Rebecca Ann Lawson. Hope Riley McClendon, cum laude. Daniel Stephen Miller. Tyler James Morgan. Jonathan Matthew Page. Haley Savannah Patterson, cum laude. Jacob Ross Price. Peyton Reese Ramsey, magna cum laude. Kaylin Felicidad Ray. Ethan Tyler Reese. Alana Hope Robinson, summa cum laude. Cheyenne Sue Rosario Reed. Rachel Ellen Rhino, summa cum laude. Donovan Edward Sharp. Haley Ann Sharp. Marissa Lynn Cheryl, cum laude. Garrett Strutton.
Isabel Catherine Tilgen.
What issue?
Amy Elizabeth Wade. Tierra Weed, summa cum laude. Ileana Catherine Willis. Natalie Lee Ann Wilfong. Silas Aaron Young. Ladies and gentlemen, the slideshow is next.
Daddy, I'm afraid. Won't you stay a little while? Keep me safe, 'cause there's monsters right outside. Daddy, please don't go. I don't want to be alone, 'cause the second that you're gone, they're gonna know. Before he went to bed, he grabbed my hand and said, just 'cause I'm leaving, it don't mean it. I won't be right by your side. When you need me, you can't see me. Gonna take me far away. I know I act tough, but there's a churning in my gut, 'cause I just can't call you up when things get rough. Before I left, he hugged my neck and said, just 'cause you're leaving, it don't mean it. I won't be right by your side. When you can't see me in the middle of the night. Just close your eyes and say a prayer. It's okay, I know you're scared. I might be here, but I'll always be right there. Even though you're leaving, I ain't going nowhere. Won't you stay a little while? I never thought I'd see the day I had to say goodbye. Daddy, please don't go. I can't do this on my own. There's no way that I can walk this road alone. Daddy grabbed my hand and said, just 'cause I'm leaving, it don't mean it. I won't be right by your side. When
Called it prison when I was growing up, but these are my roots and this is what I love. 'Cause everybody knows me and I know them, and I believe that's the way we were supposed to live. I wouldn't trade one single day here in small town USA. Give me a Saturday night, my baby by my side, a little Hank Jr. and a six pack of light, an old dirt road, and I'll be just fine. Give me a Sunday morning that's full of grace, a simple life, and I'll be okay here in small town USA. Around here we break our backs just to earn a buck. We never get ahead, but we have enough. I watch people leave and then come right back. I never wanted any part of that, and I'm proud to say I love this place, good old small town USA. And a six-pack of light, an old dirt road, and I'll be just fine. Give me a Sunday morning that's full of grace, a simple life, and I'll be okay here in small town USA. And a six pack of light, an old dirt road, and I'll be just fine. Give me a Sunday morning that's full of grace, a simple life, and I'll be okay. Yeah, I'll be okay here in small town USA. Turned on the evening news, saw an old man being interviewed, turning 102 today. They asked him what's the secret to life. He looked up from his old pipe, laughed and said, all I can say is, don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old, and you take a nap, and you wake up, and you're 25, then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink, you just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed. And you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. Well, I was glued to my TV when it looked like he looked at me and said, best start putting first things first. 'Cause when you hourglass runs out of sand, you can't rip it over and start again. Take every breath God gives you for what it's worth.
don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap and wake up and you're 25. Then your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink. You just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there and there. And you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. I've been trying to slow it down. I've been trying to take it easy. In this here today, gone tomorrow world we're living in. Don't blink. Just like that, you're 6 years old and you take a nap and you wake up and you're 25. And your high school sweetheart becomes your wife. Don't blink. Just might miss your babies growing like mine did, turning into moms and dads. Next thing you know, you better have a 50 years is there in bed. And you're praying God takes you instead. Trust me, friend, 100 years goes faster than you think. So don't blink. No, don't. Life goes faster than you
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduating class of 2020. Thank you. night's ceremony. As you leave, just a couple of announcements. The seniors will be released from the front of the building up by the cafeteria. So if you're waiting to join them, they'll be exiting the building up by the cafeteria. And just a reminder, please do your best to maintain social distance as you leave tonight. Please try to observe those guidelines. We appreciate you being here. Drive safely.